Good evening, everyone, and welcome. It's nice to see you all here this evening. I'd like to call to order our Linwood City Council business meeting for this evening, Monday, April 11th, 2016. And let's start with item 10, our flag salute. And President Boyer, would you please lead us?
Oh, me again?
Yeah, it says so.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Executive Assistant Morris, could we have the roll call, please?
Yes. Mayor Smith?
I am here.
Council President Boyer?
Here.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Present.
Councilmember Cotton?
Happy to be here.
Councilmember Ross?
Here.
Councilmember Sessions?
Here.
Councilmember Hurst?
Here.
Councilmember Sutton?
Good evening.
Council's present, Mayor.
Thank you. Moving on to item 30, this is the approval of our minutes. Councilmember Sutton, would you please do the honors?
Yes, I move to approve the following minutes. Finance Committee meeting, March 24th. Business meeting, March 28th. Work session, April 4th.
Second.
Any discussion, changes, or amendments? And these are all in 2016, the minutes. All right, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any oppositions? Thank you. The minutes are so approved. Just a few messages from me this evening. Another busy couple of weeks, the last couple of weeks. We've been continuing our work on our disaster readiness. And on April 1st, our executive leadership team met and focused on the continuity of government during a disaster. And we were joined by Dara Salmon from the DEM, the Department of Emergency Management. And then on April 6th, we hosted the first Map Your Neighborhood Ambassador meeting at Fire Station 15. Had a great turnout. I want to thank council members Sutton, Ross, and Hurst for joining us. And it's a great partnership with DEM, the City of Linwood, and Fire District 1. Last Thursday, I was really honored to participate in our police department's promotions. It's been over 2 years since they've last held promotions, and it was wonderful to see five very deserving members of our police department receive this recognition. The newly promoted members are Sergeant Scott Dilworth, Sergeant Chris Bro, Sergeant Doug Teachworth, Commander Rodney Conheim, and Deputy Chief Jim Nelson. And the reason that the promotions were available at this point is because we've had three retirements from our police department. The first one, Deputy Chief Manser, who served 28 years in Linwood, Sergeant T.J. Brooks served 30, and Sergeant Demetrick served 36. And if you add those numbers, we're just 6 years short of a century of service from those three retirees. So I want to personally thank them again in front of all of you. And Chief Jensen does a wonderful job in succession planning, so you can be sure that the people who have been promoted into these positions are well-trained, and they're super passionate about serving our city, and I'm looking very much forward to working with them. Then on April 7th, same night, actually, I attended the Citizens Academy Academy graduation ceremony. Council Member Goodwin and City Administrator Art Sinisa were going through this program. We had 42 graduates this year, many who are looking forward to moving on into the Linwood University program, where registration is now open on our website, and we'll go back to our regular Linwood University 14-week program starting in September. So please register for that if you would like to. And then lastly, we celebrated the grand opening of Cask and Trotter last week. So stop on by and get some great smoked barbecue. I don't think you'll be disappointed. Right, President Boyer?
Amen.
That's what I said. It was yummy. I'd like to move on to item 60. This is where we have some presentations and proclamations, and we actually have three this evening. So let's start with our proclamation.
Jumping over citizen comments?
Oh, I'm jumping over citizen comments, not on purpose. I was too excited about the proclamations. I even have a sign-up sheet. All right, follow the agenda. Okay, so we will move into our citizen comments. I'll start with those who've signed up on the sheet. Please come forward to the podium when I call your name, state your address and your name, and then you'll have 3 minutes to talk. So the first one on the list is Doug Shelton with Pacific Little League.
Good evening. Thank you for being here tonight and welcoming us. My goal of being here tonight is to invite you to our celebration, which is Saturday, the 23rd of April, which is a week from Saturday. Every year we have a Little League Day, and the kids come together. They do their pictures. They have games. But at 11 o'clock, we have a parade, and we always honor somebody. And this year, we'd love to honor the City of Lynnwood and the Parks and Recs Department. We have been at Lindale Park for over 50 years, so 1964, 1965. So it's been a long time, and it's been a great partnership. I want to thank Lynn Sordell and his team. They have been fantastic to work with, and, of course, the support that City Council gives us every year to use those fields. Working together, we have some of the nicest fields. And I will say, people ask us, what is the success of why do you get 800 kids in your program every year? The success is the community that we have at Lindale Park. It's such a neat place for families to come and meet and enjoy themselves. Not just the kids playing on the field, but it's the kids that get their siblings that play in the swings or play in the woods or all the other things that makes it such an enjoyable place to play. The improvements there have been great. I do want to announce that we will be hosting the 10-year-old state all-star tournament there this summer. That'll be in July, and that's a big deal. We have teams coming from all over the state of Washington. It brings people into the city of Lynnwood, brings in hotels and revenue. But it's a great tournament if you get to come out and watch. It'll start on a weekend, and it'll go probably for about 10 days. And we'll have some announcements for you on that as to when that happens, but that'll be mid-July. Anyways, I'd like to invite you guys to that. We have 800 kids. It's boys and girls ages 4 to 18. This year, I'm proud to say I'm running our special needs teams. I'm up to four teams. And if you ever get 1 o'clock on Saturdays, they play there every Saturday. Come out and watch it. This is one of the great experiences you'll ever see, to see kids with special needs get to play baseball. It's a slow enough game that they get to play. And the second inning is home run baseball. Every kid that hits the ball hits a home run. To watch them run around the bases and touch every base and usually slide into home plate is just a fantastic thing to see. And so I'd love to have you guys come see that. In the future, Lynn and I have talked a little bit about the improvements at Meadowdale Playfield. Our biggest challenge is what to do when kids turn 13 and they leave that 12-year-old 200-foot field at Lindale. We really see the numbers drop down, and a lot of that is just accessibility of fields that the kids can play on. So we've talked about that maybe at Meadowdale Playfield's extending Willis Field so the older kids can play. The fences are deep enough there. And really the only fields they have to play on now are the high school fields. And there are no lit fields except for Mount Lake Terrace High School. But again, the high schools, their baseball season using those. So we really look forward to maybe partnering with the City of Lynnwood on getting community support behind those fields and so on. So that's really all I have tonight. I have some invitations to leave with you. And love to see you there a week from Saturday. Parking is a little bit tight because this year, if you haven't been over there, Lindale Elementary has been knocked down, and it's a great thing. I think it's going to be a great improvement for that neighborhood. You're going to see a neat school going in there. It's going to be beautiful, and I think they're planning on opening next January or second semester. So they got a lot of work to do. The structure is up. The footprint is there, but it does impact our parking, so come early if you could. And the presentation's at 11, and probably you want to be there about 10:30. So anyways, thank you very much.
Thank you. Next on the list is Catherine Watkins. No, you're not going to speak. Okay. So that's it on the list. Are there others in the audience who would like to have some time to share your comments? Yes. Elizabeth.
Elizabeth Lunsford, and it's now just zip code 98037. I wanted to come to say I had a great time this past week at the Heritage Park cleanup. It was a fantastic time, and I want to do a special thanks to the Lynnwood Kiwanis Club and the Lynnwood High School Keith Club. But in particular, I want to say thank you to the Lynnwood Park and Rec Department, and especially Eric Peterson. I am continually impressed by his leadership and management skills, and I have a little story to say of what happened. There was a heavy piece of furniture that needed to be moved from the cottage or over to the Wickers building, not only to the Wickers building, but up the stairs. I was upstairs and they did not know this, and I overheard them. there was about 4 people working on moving this furniture. And if it was me, I wouldn't have the most polite words to say while lifting this piece of furniture up. But it was just laughter and joy and positivity. And I think this has mostly to do with his leadership and management skills. I have been trained, I was a military officer, and my favorite skill is leading by example. I think his professionalism and positivity is exemplary and should be honored. All right, thank you.
Yep. Thank you, Elizabeth. Yep. Are there others who would like to speak this evening? Yes, Shannon. And if you'd also write your name on the sheet, it would yes. make Beth very happy.
Hello, councilmen and women. My name is Shannon Tisland with Experience Momentum. And I just wanted to acknowledge a few people in the city that I think are doing really great things. Eric Peterson has gone out of his way to work with our company on doing a project for Earth Day. We're going to close our doors for business. And I reached out to him to see what does the city of Linwood have going on Earth Day that we could help clean up and do some things. And he said, we don't have anything on Earth Day the 22nd, but we're doing a Dale Park cleanup on the 23rd. And I said, I'd really like to get our team out there. So he brainstormed some solutions, and he's going to have the truck out there. And we're going to clean up the inner urban trail on Earth Day itself and just try to make a statement for what's going on with Earth Day. So, yes, I think Eric is great to piggytail off of what Elizabeth said. Also, I believe March 19th, the city put together an inner urban trail get together on what's going on, and it was a great community involvement. Lynn was there, and it was just fun to brainstorm with community members on what they'd like to see for the city of Linwood, and I just thought that was fantastic. And then I also want to recognize Sarah Olson, who's doing an amazing job with the Healthy Communities Initiative and what she's doing to try and make Linwood just a healthy place to bring in new people, new things, and help us stay healthy. So everyone is doing a great job. Thank you.
Thank you, Shannon. Are there others who'd like to speak this evening? All right. Well, thank you. Now, President Boyer says we can do proclamations. So the first one, we're on to item 60. The first one is a proclamation and presentation with regard to volunteers. And I think Councilmember Sessions.
Yes, I'm happy to do that.
Yeah. Are there, Marielle, did you guys work this out?
Yes, we did.
Okay. So do you want Shannon at the podium? Yeah,
okay.
Why don't you go to the podium and read that since
wonderful.
People works.
Thank you. It's my honor to talk about the proclamation for volunteers tonight. Formerly, I was worked for the Linwood Police Department for a lot of years, and part of my job was coordinating a big section of the police volunteers. And I tell you, I know what they do. It's a ton. And then also being part of putting together recognition events for the citywide volunteers, it just completely continues to inspire me on how much folks do, not only for the city, but around the city and in the community. So I'm so happy you guys could join us tonight for this special proclamation. It's for National Volunteer Week 2016. Whereas the entire community can affect positive change with any volunteer action, no matter how big or small, and whereas volunteers can connect with local community service opportunities through hundreds of community service organizations, and whereas millions of volunteers working in their communities utilize their time and talents daily to make a real difference, and whereas the giving of oneself in service to another empowers the giver and the recipient, and whereas the week of April 10th through 16th is National Volunteer Week, and the City of Linwood wishes to express sincere appreciation to our city volunteers and those that volunteer in our community and recognize their commitment to service, and whereas the city's volunteer force of more than 300 individuals who contributed over 21,948 hours of service in 2015 alone is an invaluable treasure that is vital to our future as a caring and productive community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that we, Mayor Nicholas Smith and the Linwood City Council, proclaim April 10th through 16th, 2016, as National Volunteer Week in the City of Linwood, and we encourage our fellow citizens to volunteer and light the way in their community. And I move that the City Council also concurs.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you. And if I could have Marielle join me.
Okay. Howdy. So we have about six or seven groups that we want to recognize today, individuals and service groups who gave countless hours to improve our parks and our trails. So I'm going to go ahead and read through the groups, and as I do, we'll stop and present them with a certificate and then take a photo. So the first is Trevor Kinman. Let me just come up. Trevor is from the Boy Scout Troop 312. He completed a restoration project on the Mesquistead Trail as his Eagle Scout service project. Trevor and his group graveled the entire trail, constructed new railings for one of the bridges crossing the creek. Home Depot donated lumber for the project. Trevor had over 20 volunteers working over 2 days, contributing a total of 133 service hours.
Yeah. So why don't you come here? Marielle and Shannon, you come with him here.
Oh, sure.
Mm-hmm. And we'll stand.
All rise.
All right. Can you see President?
Can everybody see Julie?
Yeah, I know.
Well done.
Thank you.
There you go, Shannon.
Jaden. Jaden of Troop 312 installed two benches at the Lindale Park Amphitheater in addition to spreading 40 yards of bark mulch to landscape areas throughout the park. He completed this work as a requirement for his Eagle Scout service project. Volunteers worked over 2 days to total logged 50 service hours. Next is the Snohomish County Campfire Club. Snohomish County Campfire Club participated in a spring floral bed planting at Wilcox Park. Want to come forward? And can you pronounce your club's name?
Camp Kalopua.
No, not Camp Kalopua.
Okay. Our club's name is Shige Tli Du.
I think that means...
Sure.
Okay. Is anyone from Life Point Church here? Okay, I'll go ahead and share what they were involved with. They had a two-day landscape cleanup event at Stadler Ridge Park where volunteers pulled weeds, spread beauty bark throughout the whole park for a total of 300 volunteer hours. Yeah. Shannon with Experience Momentum.
Experience Momentum is the first group to participate in our Adopt a Trail program. Their first project involved landscape improvements and general cleanup along the inner urban trail. Volunteers removed 10 yards of invasive plant material and continue to make improvements today.
Finally getting it.
Oh, I skipped them. Next is the Brighton School Destination Imagine Third Rock team. They volunteered at South Linwood Neighborhood Park, removing invasive plants and general cleanup. And we have several of them here today. Okay, and the last one this evening is the Linwood Senior Center Hiking Club. The Linwood Senior Center Hiking Club worked to make improvements at Scriber Lake by placing 15 yards of wood chips on the trails last fall. Like it, right?
Thank you, Marielle, for your leadership in our programs. The second proclamation is our proclamation for Stand Against Racism. And if I could have Councilmember Hurst go to the podium and ask Marianne Dillon and Vicky Von Stube to join him.
Great. And I think Marianne's going to have some words before we do the proclamation.
Okay. Thank you. I am Marianne Dillon. I'm with the YWCA. With me, I have Vicky Von Stube. Thank you, Mayor Smith. Thank you, City Council. Thank you, City Councilman Hurst. So the City of Linwood is a long-time and valued partner with our YWCA, and we very much appreciate this proclamation and your continued commitment against racism. The Stand Against Racism is an annual YWCA campaign. Its intent to build community among those who work for racial justice and to raise awareness about the negative impact of institutional and structural racism in our communities. This campaign is one part of our larger national strategy to fulfill our YWCA mission of eliminating racism. Our Standing Together Against Racism today reminds us that there is still work to be done in our community and that together we can make a difference. Thank you for highlighting this important issue and for taking a stand against racism. And Vicky and I brought you some pins we hope you might wear.
While we do the proclamation.
Oh, sure.
While we're doing pictures. Okay, and I will now read the proclamation. Whereas all people of Linwood, regardless of race, creed, or ethnicity, deserve to be treated with dignity, respect, compassion, and justice, And whereas racism prevents individuals from fully participating in and contributing to their community, eliminating racism and racial discrimination will allow us to celebrate the richness of diversity. And whereas the elimination of racism can be achieved only with the participation of all people in dialogue, reflection, and action, and whereas our shared goal is to advocate for increased awareness of the lasting and negative effects of racism in our communities, institutions, and personal relationships, and whereas the YWCA of Seattle Kings Snohomish, along with the City of Lynnwood, local businesses, community organizations, schools, and places of worship, celebrate diversity and advocate for the elimination of racism. Now, therefore, be it resolved that we, Mayor Nicholas Smith and the Lynnwood City Council, proclaim April 29th, 2016, as Stand Against Racism Day in the City of Lynnwood, and we encourage our fellow citizens to make a personal commitment to stand against racism. And so I'll ask the council to affirm this, please.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Thank you. So photo op? Sure. George, if, or you want to, you've already spoken. Okay, buttons and photo op.
You can put the buttons on before.
Thank you, Vicki. Now you're really blocked.
Thank you.
There's no one receiving the proclamation, so you can stay here. Unless you really want to go down. Oh, all right. Thank you, Marianne and Vicki. It's good to see you here. Our last proclamation of the day is for, or this evening, is for Earth Day, and Council Vice President Goodwin will be delivering this message.
Thank you, Mayor. Earth Day Network Proclamation. Whereas the global community now faces extraordinary challenges, such as global health issues, food and water shortages, and economic struggles. And whereas all people, regardless of race, gender, income, or geography, have a moral right to a healthy, sustainable environment with economic growth. And whereas it is understood that the citizens of the global community must step forward and take action to create a green economy to combat the aforementioned global challenges. And whereas a green economy can be achieved on the individual level through educational efforts, public policy, and consumer activism campaigns. And whereas the citizens of the City of Lynnwood have embraced the goal to be a regional model for a sustainable, vibrant community. And whereas Lynnwood Park Service volunteers help to maintain and improve Lynnwood's parks through their dedication and contribution of many hours. And whereas the City of Lynnwood hereby encourages its residents, businesses, and institutions to use Earth Day to celebrate the Earth and commit to building a sustainable community. And whereas the City of Lynnwood, in partnership with the Global Peace Youth Foundation, will celebrate Earth Day with an Earth Day cleanup project to restore, remove invasive plant material, and placement of wood chips in the playground at Dale Way Park from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Saturday, April 23rd. Now, therefore, be it resolved that we, the Mayor and the City Council of the City of Lynnwood, do hereby pledge this Earth Day, April 22nd, 2016, to renew our commitment to the sustainability framework as expressed in our comprehensive plan, and as the path towards becoming the sustainable community as envisioned by our citizens. And I ask that the City Council move that we affirm this resolution.
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much. So, Shannon, can people join the party on Friday? So you have two times this next weekend where you can participate, one with Experience Momentum and our park crew, starting at Experience Momentum on the Interurban Trail, and then again at Dale Way Park, again with our parks crew. Is your staff big enough, Lynn? No, that was a don't ask. On Saturday from 9 to 2. So we hope to see many of you there joining us. So with that, that ends our presentations and proclamations. And I would certainly invite those of you who don't want to stay for the rest of the meeting, you could leave now, but, you know, it's going to be a stimulating meeting, so you might want to stay. Where else have you got to go? Oh, all right, all right.
Sure.
Right? Oh, painful. I know. So just moving into item 70, are there any written communications that I have not received? All right. So at this time, we'll move into item 80, our council comments and announcements. And it looks like Councilmember Ross, you get to kick us off.
Hey, okay. Yes, very quickly. I did have a very successful meeting with the Parks Board last week. We had Dustin and David come and give the presentation about the fascinating and wonderful upcoming help from the federal government about transit-oriented development. Mm-hmm. And if you are watching this on tape delayed on Wednesday, you need to get your party clothes on because you're late to the volunteer recognition event. So all of our volunteers are going to come to our party because we appreciate them and love them so. If you're watching this after Wednesday, you missed it. So sorry. That's all I have.
Thank you. Councilmember Cotton.
Thank you, Your Honor. First off, as I won't be in attendance on the evening of the 13th, I want to just take this opportunity to thank all of our volunteers. I know that we all here at the city know that, I mean, a bulk of very much heavy lifting happens on the shoulders of our volunteers, and we're very thankful for all of them. Second thing is, as the TBD board president, the Transportation Benefit District, I did want to announce that we do have a April 20th meeting scheduled at 7 p.m. here in the City Hall in the Council Chambers, and we'll be discussing the Transportation Benefit District measures and just general talking about roads there. And just lastly, I want to frame this correctly just so that everyone knows my heart in this. I think that all of our boards and commissions in our city are important and valuable, and when one of them isn't working or isn't fully staffed, it saddens me. And so I just wanted to lend my voice to saying that I think it's important that we do something about the Diversity Commission. My heart is just to see that commission repaired and restored. So that's why I'm saying this. It's not, there's no motive other than just to see that commission restored. So I would love to see any applicants that have put their name in the hat prior to or recently, anybody that's interested in that commission. I know that we had a great success recently with the Human Services Commission, so I know the city has a great number of people that are willing to put their time in. So I would just say, if we have any applicants, I would be very excited to entertain them. So, thank you.
Thank you. Councilmember Sutton.
Thank you very much. I've had a busy week, and I'm just going to kind of share my experiences this week. Everything I do, I always learn something from it. And so I am the appointed liaison to the Heritage Park Board Commission. And so on Wednesday, I was one of those people that went out and volunteered my services for the spring cleanup. It was very exhilarating. Looking at all the youth there, we had babies and strollers and seniors and elders, and it was just really a fantastic day of sun. And I had almost wished that we had a water fight or balloon fight because it was getting so warm at one point in time. But that didn't happen. But my takeaway, not only with sore muscles, but it was learning about the famous interurban trolley and trails and the historic impact that it has on our city of Lynnwood. So again, if you've not been there, if you've not ventured into that area, please go and visit, because it was very exhilarating just to see the history that they display there. On Thursday, April 7, that was the first meeting of the Human Services Commission, which I was appointed liaison to. The commission elected a chair and a vice chair, developed a list of trusted individuals who they can invite to come before them for advice and collaboration. They reviewed the commission's purpose and shared their expectations for serving. All seven members were seated at this dais, and their names promptly displayed. And I'm hoping that this is going to be a consistency amongst all the other commissions, too. In borrowing a line from the proclamation Stand Against Racism, which read, whereas the elimination of racism can be achieved only with the participation of all people in dialogue and reflection and action, I attended a two-day session on Friday, diversity and inclusion over at the University of Bothell campus, and it was very well attended. I'm always trying to upgrade my knowledge around culture and peoples, and so I then went back on Saturday and attended the Restorative Justice event, which was put on by the Communities of Color Coalition, and it was absolutely amazing. Not only were their speakers very well informed in terms of racism and institutional racism and just acceptance of justice and being very kind and understanding the philosophy of nonviolence. It was a very worthwhile weekend. And I came away with thinking that if we as individuals reach out to learn more about each other, we would be a better nation. The last thing I'd like to share is that there is a poverty workshop simulation that's going to be held. And let me get to that information here. One way of learning about how poverty affects us or anything is to walk in the shoes. And that's what I do believe in terms of my learning and experience and maturing as an adult. But anyway, there's a poverty simulation which would be in will be held on April the 22nd. It will be at the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints in Arlington, Washington. And it is basically an actual experience. It will be a half a day workshop. And if you are interested in learning more about this or to sign up, please connect with our council representative, Beth Morris, and her number is 425-670-5011. That's 425-670-5011. I assure you, you will look and learn, and this is what we are seeing here with homelessness amongst many cities definitely is something that I think will be more of a broadening experience for us all. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilmember Hurst?
Great. Couple things. First of all, it was wonderful to hear that the Lynnwood Kiwanis were recognized for the Heritage Park cleanup. Also, they're not only the Key Club, I understand that there was a Builders Club, which is the middle school branch of Kiwanis. And I'm a member of Kiwanis. They meet at 7 in the morning, I don't know, but I'm supposed to show devotion, but it's every Thursday morning at 7 o'clock at Fire Station 15. And anybody who wants to belong to a great service club is invited to attend. Also, I'd like to say something about the proclamation about Stand Against Racism. Usually when proclamations are read, sometimes they're read, they're forgotten. But this one really made me think about what was going on in our country. In the history of our country, we've tried to legislate against racism. We did it with constitutional amendments after the Civil War. 100 years later, we did it with the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act. And yet, during my lifetime, it was considered appropriate to put signs over public facilities to bar people from going into them, or even to decide who can drink out of a water fountain. And then, growing up in the 60s, civil rights leaders were murdered. Seemed every summer there was a race riot and cities burned. In 2008 we elected our first black president. And yet, this last year, again, we had race riots, we had cities burning. We have state legislatures who are looking at legislation to limit voting rights. And we have, politicians talking about deporting people or barring people from entering the United States because of their religion. And I just think, it made me think that really fighting racism is not going to happen from the top down. It's going to be individuals. And it's going to take individuals who see a wrong or experience a wrong to stand up and say, this is not going to be tolerated in America. And so it really affected me to be able to think about that proclamation and to read it. And I thank you.
Thank you. Councilmember Sessions?
Thank you. I'm going to piggyback on a couple things the mayor said. She and I were present at the Linwood Police Promotions last week, and just really pleased by that. I know all of those officers, and they're all very worthy for those positions. Again, just congratulations to the new sergeants, Sergeant Bro, Sergeant Dilworth, Sergeant Teachworth, and new Commander Conheim, and the new Deputy Chief Nelson. Very pleased about that and the momentum over there. It's exciting and great for morale, and it's a good thing. And also, piggybacking on the graduation of the Linwood Police Citizens Academy, that was the 25th Citizens Academy Linwood Police have done, and there were 42 graduates. That program over the years have been 12 to 14 weeks, depending on the year, and it takes the effort of a major effort of the crime prevention section, the volunteers, and officers from each and every section of the police department to be committed to that. And while different police academies have come and gone all around the Puget Sound area, Linwood still has stayed and stronger than ever. And so just really pleased by that. And we get a lot of our volunteers from that program as well. And so congratulations to them on a lot of hard work and good work on that. And then lastly, I want to remind everyone about our Veterans One-Stop Resource Center. We talked about this before, right after they opened, but I want to remind everyone, attention all veterans and their families, that we now have available to veterans and their families is the One-Stop Resource Center, staffed by local professionals available to assist you with referrals to Veterans Affairs, medical and employment assistance, career transitions, and even just a cup of coffee with friendly conversation. It's, again, invited all veterans and their families, open every Tuesday and the first Wednesday of each month from 9 to 3. And it's located currently at the Verdant Community Wellness Center in the Madrona Room. And that's there on 196 next to Applebee's at 4710 196th Street in Linwood. And they'd love to see you over there. Thanks.
Thank you. Vice President Goodwin.
Thank you. I would like to remind everyone that may be here and watching that the public comment period for the pharmaceutical stewardship program that is in consideration through the Snohomish County Health District is open until the 15th of April. So if you have ideas, questions, comments, anything about that program, or just want to find out more information, you can either visit www.snohd.org. You can also email the district at medicines@snohd.org or mail comments to the Snohomish Health District, Attention Pharmaceutical Stewardship Comments. And that address is 3020 Rucker Avenue, Suite 306, Everett, Washington 98201. And I also wanted to make a quick comment about the Police Citizens Academy. I had the opportunity of attending that along with the city administrator. And the last day, which was last Thursday, Lisa Wellington, who is one of the people in charge and helped to run the academy, she asked volunteers to kind of give their perspectives of what it was like to go through this academy. And every one of the people that spoke said that they learned so much about the police department. And the key that they learned was the decisions that they have to make in such a short period of time, are no match for any decisions that we have to make outside of that realm. When you have to think as quick as they do in dangerous, often violent or threatening situations, it's very difficult. And to make the decisions that they have to make, as professional as especially our police department makes them, is it's fantastic. And so it was a great opportunity for myself and for the citizens that spoke at that meeting to say, you know, I really respect what the police officers in our city do and the compassion and the caring that they have for the citizens of the city of Glenwood. And anyone that has an opportunity to, I would challenge you and urge you to do that program when it rolls around again. It's a fantastic opportunity. It's actually fun, engaging, and you will learn a lot about the police officers, and you'll get a different perspective than you've had before. Thanks.
Thank you. And President Boyer.
Thank you, Your Honor. I first of all want to join my colleagues who cited Linwood's amazing cadre of volunteers tonight. Like my friend Mr. Cotton, I won't be available to be at the volunteer appreciation dinner because of some professional commitments. But pretty much my entire professional life has been spent in the nonprofit sector, and I know very deeply how valuable volunteers are to most of the wonderful things that happen in our community, so I salute Linwood's volunteers. I also wanted to remark on the situation with the Diversity Commission, just to say these things take time sometimes to work out. I was a member of the Arts Commission in Linwood before I was ever a city council member. And shortly after I left that commission to focus on some other things, that commission also had its crisis and was down to just a couple of members and ended up needing to be put on hiatus for some months until the membership could be rebuilt and restored. So these things are important, but sometimes a little time is necessary to make sure things work out. We've had the civil rights movement called out already this evening, and to cite one of my heroes from those days, Dr. King, the moral arc of the universe is long, but it bends toward justice. And so sometimes we just have to be patient. And to that point, the Arts Commission now, a couple of years after those crisis days, is up and operating in fantastic ways, I think stronger than ever. I'm sorry Beth Lunsford's already left, and she won't hear me say this, but this Arts Commission is just doing great work and has right now no less than 3 exhibits on city property. Here in this building, there's the primary gallery, which used to be at the library before some changes there necessitated its moving. And from now until June 2nd, we have the artwork of Susan Pettit, or perhaps she pronounces it Petit, from Issaquah. Her grandmother was also a well-known artist and illustrator, and so Susan takes her cue from that and works on nature. And animals and urban life combined, some fabulous pieces. Also, over at the library, there is still an arts display in the display case at the library. And from April 2nd to June 2nd, we have the work of Danielle Earhart, who is a native of Montreal in Canada, and she has some beautiful little pieces over there. And then finally, in our Linwood Rec Center, we now have a youth art gallery. And from March 8 until April 12th, so actually just tomorrow, is hung the work of Jamie Campbell, a 16-year-old resident of Kenmore. Again, I would urge you to go and check that out at the Rec Center. So we've got three wonderful displays up now by the Arts Commission. Commissions do sometimes take a little time off and come back stronger than ever. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for all your comments. At this time, I would like to introduce Emily Scott to the council. She's back here in the left-hand corner waving at you. She is working with Linwood Today and covering our council meetings until further noticed, I hear. Good. Welcome, Emily.
Good job, guys.
Thank you. All right, moving on to 90, business items and other matters. 90.1, our unanimous consent agenda. Council Vice President Goodwin.
Thank you, Mayor. If you're not sick of me yet, just wait.
I'm not.
Would any council member like to remove any item from the consent agenda? Nope, good. I move to adopt the following consent agenda items. Contract award, digital evidence storage. Authorize the mayor to enter into a contract with Taser International, evidence.com for a one-year software subscription with up to four annual renewals. The estimated cost is $9,000 for the first year with an estimated total of $45,000 over the course of 5 years, inclusive of sales tax. Item B, contract award inmate foods. Authorize the mayor to enter into an interlocal agreement with Correctional Industries, Washington State Department of Corrections, for the provision of prepared meals for up to 5 years. The estimated annual cost of this contract is $100,000 per year, inclusive of sales tax. Item C, funding contract, Linwood Senior Center and Snohomish County Human Services. Authorize the mayor to sign a contract with Snohomish County Human Services to receive $23,000 in funding for staffing and contract instructors. And D, voucher approval. Approved claims and payroll in the amount of $3,891,616.94 and $1,259,556.07, respectively.
Thank you. Our consent agenda will be adopted as read. No public hearings tonight. A little bit about 90.3, our other business items. We have two ordinances and a business license code amendment to approve. Then we'll be moving into an executive session and then coming back to the dais for final action. All right. So with that, council members, is there someone who would take on 90.3A, ordinance and updated financial plan? Council Member Cotton, thank you. Oh, it's your tie.
Try your iPad.
How about that? Okay, fantastic. Ooh. Check. Council Executive Assistant, may I have an ordinance number, please?
3187.
Mm-hmm. All right. I move that the City Council of the City of Linwood pass ordinance number 3187, an ordinance of the City of Linwood, Washington, superseding ordinance number 3092, updating the financial for the Inner Urban Trail South Segment Missing Link Project, parentheses 212th Street Southwest at 63rd Avenue West, end parentheses. This ordinance authorizes project expenditures in fund number 350 and funding allocations and transfers from fund 331 to fund 350, and consistent with the project financial plan and providing for severability and effective date and summary publication.
Second.
Thank you. Councilmember Cotton, would you like to speak to the ordinance?
Yes, absolutely. So this is a little bit of cleanup in accordance with the project that was already funded under the previous ordinance 3092. There ended up being some right-of-way acquisition that was needed and some additional funding for design as required by PSC to complete the project that's already currently underway, as I understand it. So that would, this is, this ordinance and the two follow-up items are meant to facilitate those pieces.
Thank you. Any other questions or comments? Can I have a roll call vote, please?
Council President Boyer?
Aye.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Affirmative.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
Councilmember Roth?
Yes.
Councilmember Sessions?
Yes.
Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Seven yes, Mayor.
Thank you. Ordinance number 3187 passes unanimously. And Councilmember Cotton, will you carry on?
Yes, I will. On to part two. I move that the City Council of the City of Linwood authorize the mayor to enter into and execute on behalf of the city a contract supplement number 5 with SVR Design Group of Seattle, Washington, additional design services in an amount not to exceed $83,600, which is consistent with the financial plan. Sales tax does not apply.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion?
This is just, this is the follow-up piece. Now that we've authorized the additional expenditures under 3187, this is the part where the additional design scope as added by PSC needs to be covered by SVR.
Thank you. Any other questions or comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposition? So moved. And three.
And three. I move that the City Council of the City of Linwood authorize the mayor to enter into and execute on behalf of the city a contract with Rolland Resources of Bellevue, Washington, right-of-way services in an amount not to exceed $38,500, which is consistent with the financial plan. Sales tax does not apply.
Second.
Thank you. Any comments or questions?
I'll just add that this is the last piece where some right-of-way acquisition was required, and the Rolland Resources Group is going to help us with some of that right-of-way acquisition and the legal paperwork that needs to go along with that.
Thank you. Any more comments, questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposition? So moved. We'll move on to Ordinance B and financial plan for vendor services contract. Any takers? Vice President Goodwin?
Ordinance number, please.
3188.
I move that we as a city council adopt ordinance number 3188, an ordinance of the City of Linwood, Washington, establishing project funding for the 2016 Pavement Management System Ratings Project and authorizing project expenditures in Fund 311 and funding allocations and transfers from Fund 331 to Fund 311. And consistent with the project financial plan and providing for severability, an effective date, and summary publication.
Second. Thank you. Would you like to speak to the ordinance?
Basically, this plan is a systems rating project. It helps to support our community vision to invest in efficient, integrated local and regional transportation systems. And it's geared to help improve the city's infrastructure that links all of those plans together.
Thank you. Any other comments or questions? All those in favor, please.
Roll call, please.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Yes.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
Councilmember Ross?
Yes.
Councilmember Sessions?
Yes.
Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Council President Boyer?
Aye.
Seven yes, Mayor.
Thank you. Ordinance 3188 passes unanimously. And the second part?
Part number two. I move that we, the Linwood City Council, authorize the mayor to enter into and execute on behalf of the city a contract with Infrastructure Management Services, a pavement distress data collection firm, in an amount not to exceed $138,500, including management reserve of $12,362. Sales tax does not apply.
Second. Any questions or comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposition? So moved. Moving on to 90.3C, this is our business license code amendments. Councilmember Ross?
Sure, thank you. And that is 3189?
Correct.
Ah, very good. I would move an ordinance of the City Council of the City of Linwood, Washington, related to licensing and regulation of businesses, adding a new section, LMC 5.04.010, amending LMC 3.104.010, LMC 5.04.020, LMC 5.04.030, LMC 5.04.040, LMC 5.04.045, and LMC 5.06.010. Recodifying LMC 5.04.090, repealing LMC 5.04.042, and LMC 5.04.050. I need to read these before I volunteer.
You're doing great.
And providing for an effective date, severability, and summary publication.
Second.
Thank you. Would you like to speak to the ordinance?
I would like to read two parts of this ordinance. The first part says, whereas many of the provisions of Title V LMC were enacted in 1959 as part of the city's first municipal code, and 57 years later, shockingly enough, no longer provide effective and efficient provisions regarding businesses and the licensing of businesses. I know, it's hard to believe. So, taking the bull by the horns, whereas using lean principles, an interdepartmental workshop of city employees identified numerous regulatory and procedural improvements that will eliminate waste, promote understanding of city regulations and licensing requirements, and normalize business regulations that have become ineffectual due to the passage of time. So this is a pretty big deal for our business license folks, and I think probably the biggest part is that now licenses will be 365 days from the day you apply, as opposed to all of them expiring on the 1st of January when we're closed. It's good. This is good. Good.
This is good. Thank you.
Very good thing.
Councilmember Cotton?
Oh.
Move your iPad.
Maybe not. Be healed.
So, everything that Councilmember Ross just said, absolutely, and I would just commend city staff for employing lean principles in a legislative and legal environment. That's really exciting to see that applied. Also, I think just the word out is that now if you're a vendor or a business that's just coming to do business in the city for a short period of time, mm-hmm. now you can just get a business license that is scaled for the scope of work you're going to do. So you don't have to buy a year-long license just to do a month-long project in the city, so which I think is fair. And so that's an exciting piece. And then the third is that this is the first of what I believe are two additional rewrites, which we will be seeing hopefully in the next year or so, that will include some additional discussions about general services and service and fee structure. So that's exciting.
Thank you. Vice President Goodwin?
Thank you. I really want to thank Corbett Locke and the staff for the wonderful job that they did in going through all the information and bringing this forward to us. I will definitely support this, and also assuming that Councilman Ross got all her 0.0.0 correct, and I think we're good. So thank you very much.
Councilmember Sessions?
Just continuing on, there's a lot of hard work on this. Really pleased with all the hard work Corbett Locke did, and we went over this several times, and so we feel really comfortable about it. And like the temporary fishing license, I was really happy about that too, that folks come in and just to do some business didn't have to get an annual permit to do that. And that was really good. And the difference in the calendar year too, and a variety of things, it was really needed. And that was a lot of work. Thank you to you and your team.
And Councilmember Hurst.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate all the work that's gone into this. I would like to see a change. There's some inconsistency in the fees, and so I would just point out those to the council for consideration. I do see that the investigation fee was increased from $40 to $56, which is great.
Do you want to name what page you're on?
Well, right now, I'm going to turn you to page 8.4 of the fee schedule, because my concern is that there is one exception to this increase to $56.50, and that is for the day spas. That investigation fee stayed for $40 for some reason. I don't know if that was a deliberate or if that was unintentional. That that is not consistent with all the other fees, investigation fees within the ordinance.
Corbett, do you have a response? Do you find where we are?
Yes, I do see this, and I think it is consistent with some. Some are 40, and some are 56. And so it's partially consistent, but overall, all of these fees do need some tweaking. If this is a change that is important to you today, feel free to make that amendment as part of your motion. If not, we will be bringing a wholesale update of the fee schedule back to you later this year. It will be much more comprehensive. We didn't at this time attempt to fix all of the anomalies in the fees that we know of, because this was kind of a surgical strike to go in and fix certain things and to be able to have it be a finite project. And so there are some other fees, for example, up above under public bathhouses. That's an investigation fee of $40 as well. So there is some consistency, but throughout, I'm sure there are inconsistencies as well.
So the intent is to come back,
yes,
with a review,
yes,
fairly soon.
Yes. Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Council President Boyer.
I just wanted to point out that another one of those little injustices that was corrected. For years, we would have folks come in to the rec center to teach art classes or dance classes or, you know, some recreation classes, and they would have to pay as much for their business license to come in and teach those classes as they made from teaching classes. So it became essentially a volunteer position by default without those people's will. So I think it's a good thing that we have dropped the requirement for those occasional teachers working for the city to have a business license just to come in and teach kids swimming or whatever it is they're doing.
Thank you. Any more discussion?
Mayor Smith,
yes.
May I?
Yes, Corbett.
Can I offer just one point of clarification, I think for our TV audience more than anyone, is that the matter of changing the term of the business license from calendar year to 365 days, there's going to be a need for a couple-month delay in the implementation of that, as we're about to launch the next Munis software, and that is for business licensing. We need that software in order to do the mechanics of it. So it won't be ready tomorrow, but we're going to bring our forces onto that, and some of these other amendments were needed for that. So it won't start tomorrow, but it'll start very soon.
Thank you. Any other comments? Roll call vote, mm-hmm. please.
Council Vice President Goodwin?
Affirmative.
Councilmember Hurst?
Yes.
Councilmember Ross?
Yes.
Councilmember Sessions?
Yes.
Councilmember Sutton?
Yes.
Council President Boyer?
Aye.
Councilmember Cotton?
Yes.
Seven yes, Mayor.
Thank you. Ordinance number 3189 passes unanimously, and we will look forward to your return, Corbett Locke. Thank you. The return. All right. At this time, we're going to move into an executive session. Council, do you need a 5-minute break on the way?
Sure.
Okay. So we will convene in the conference room in the back at 8:15. We have two topics of discussion. One is potential litigation, and the other is actual litigation. And Jim, how much time do we need for you? 10. So we're looking at 15 minutes. So we will be back at the dais at 8:30, unless I come back and share otherwise. Thank you. All right. Okay, thank you. So council has reconvened. We are moving on to new business, item number 100. And I would like to offer a council member to provide a motion. Councilmember Goodwin.
Thank you, Your Honor. I move that we, the City Council of the City of Lynnwood, authorize the mayor to sign a separation and release agreement for both Carrie Oliverson and Clarice Jack, and this is in part due to the IT department and the restructuring efforts.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposition? Thank you, Council. Is there any other new business that I haven't been told about? No?
Then I move to adjourn.
All right.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Have a good night.